Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we're diving into Microworkers and exploring the new builder template for creating a campaign. Whether you're new to Microworkers or looking to optimize your campaigns, this tutorial will guide you through the process step by step. First things first, make sure you're logged into your Microworkers account. Once you're in, navigate to the builder section by clicking on Create TTP Campaign tab. You will see three options on this page. Click on the last option. Here you will see the category list on the left side. By default, the selected template is offer or sign up category. On the right side is a preview of all templates under this category, which makes it easier for you to see which template would be helpful for your campaign objective. Today our campaign objective is to ask workers to check and filter images to make sure they meet specific rules and criteria before they go live on a website or app. This falls under content moderation category. Click on it. All template previews are now loaded on the right side. Based on these previews, which show task instructions, the best template that matches our campaign objective is image moderation. We suggest using Hiregroup for this type of category. Check out the cost display, 5 cents. The best group to hire for this type of category is MW Best Rated Countries, although you can still hire any group you prefer. Set time to finish. A typical image moderation campaign does not need to exceed 3 minutes. Take note that workers find campaigns with lower TTF more attractive than those lengthy ones. Just make sure that what you enter here is enough time for workers to complete the job. Available positions. If you are a beginner employer at Microworkers, you might want to test your campaign and see how it pans out. Unlike in Basic, where the minimum number of positions is 30, here in HG, you can open a campaign with at least one position. Let's add more to make it 50 positions. Max positions a worker can accept. By default, it is set to 1. This means that each worker can only work on the job once. Changing it to 2 or higher increases the number of times the worker can accept the job. But if you set it to 0, worker can do the jobs unlimited times. Minimum payment per task is displayed here. You can increase payout in this box. Actually, if you want to hire a large group of workers, you may contact us so we can set up a special pricing. This is the estimated campaign cost. $3. The breakdown for this is 5 cents times 50 positions plus 1 cent fee for every successful task that costs below 10 cents. Note that you will be charged only for tasks you rate satisfied. Here you will see what the template will look like. On the right side, this table shows the base steps. This means that for this 5 cent cost, you can create 2 simple task instructions and 1 moderation step. A task instruction step is a generic step where you can provide some instructions. You can see that the quantity says 1 of 2. This means you can still add another step as long as it is not a primary step. In this case, first task instruction step asks worker to look at the following image and tick the boxes. Next is the moderation step, which only shows 1 variable for the image and proof requirement. The point of having this builder is to lessen the effort of editing or creating a campaign. So basically, this remains as it is for this particular campaign. But if you need to change step 1, click Switch to Builder Mode. Click the pen icon to edit this step. An edit box will open below with the following tabs: Instructions, Important, Note, and Proofs. Step says, look at the following image and tick the box or boxes to select what the image shows. I don't need to change it anymore because it is just so basic. Important tab can be blank as you see here, or you can add. If you do this, you'll be added to a special group for more upcoming HG campaigns. Changes are applied real time, so now you'll see the pink line up here. Click the note tab. Let's add one more line here. Does the image contain shocking or disturbing content? You might have noticed the double asterisk before and after the word. This is to format the word in bold. You can learn more about formatting your text and variables by clicking this gray button. The show or hide helpful functions. We can get to use some of them later. For now, let's focus on completing your step 1. Click to hide it again. Since this step 1 is not really asking you to go to a different page or website, there is no need to add proof in this step. So, to save step 1, click on Save Step. Editing image for step 2. Click the pen icon to edit this step. 2 edit boxes will appear below. To understand what this means, click the Show or Hide Helpful Functions. In simple terms, image is a picture that is taken from website listed in variable text 1. Text 1 box here shows the link to your Google Drive, Imgur, Awesome Screenshot, or any website or directory where you saved your photo. Let's close this again to focus more on finishing step 2. I'll skip the Important and Note tab because there's nothing to be added there. Here's the proof section for this step. A proof requirement already exists, but I'd like to make a few changes to it. To edit, click on the pen icon. The details are displayed below. I just want to add another option, which is shocking or disturbing. Click on Add Choice, type shocking or disturbing. Then to move it up the list, click the arrow up. You can rearrange the choices according to how you see fit. Okay, I'm done with the proof requirement. I will just save it by clicking Save Proof button, then Save Step button. Adding a step. Just click Add New Step. You can choose what step you want to add. Let's click on Moderation to add another image. A blank instruction box appears below. Look at the right side of the page. An additional 1 cent cost per task is automatically added to your total campaign cost, so it becomes 6 cents. To make this easier, I can just copy what was written in step 2. But to be able to do that, I have to click Save Step button first to save this step 3. Click the pen icon in step 2, copy what's listed in the instructions part, then to paste it in step 3, click the pen icon here, and paste. Change text 1 variable to text 2. Now go get your image URL from your website and paste it in your text 2 variable. Now a new image is displayed in your template. To add proof requirement in step 3 that looks the same as step 2, click the Proofs tab. Click Multiple Choice. You can copy the above label and paste it here. Proof name should be unique so you can use proof 2. Leave required checked, then display as checks for checkboxes just like in step 2. Click Add Choice button so you can add the remaining options. Type all the choices one by one, or you can copy and paste them one by one. Whatever works for you. Once done, save proof, then save step. Campaign title. Start by giving your campaign a clear and descriptive name. This helps you easily identify it later. Enter here, image moderation, adult content. QT is required or optional. Required means that this campaign will only be available to workers who passed qualification test. Optional means your campaign will be open to workers who passed or failed qualification test. Time to rate, 3 days. 3 days is enough for this campaign. The lower the TTR, the more attractive your campaign is to workers. Task rating option. Select which best works for you. The most common choices here are admin review and employer rate only. Now all you have to do is click the Create Campaign and go to Next. Scroll down to click Preview and Confirmation. Then Confirm and OK to really submit the campaign for review. To see your submitted campaigns, just click on My TTV Campaigns and it will display a list. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave any questions or comments down below. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye!